Welcome to the English class. I hope you all are happy and fine. So, dear students, let us do a quick recap of what we have done in our previous class. So, in the recap part, let us discuss what we did in our previous class. That is rhyming words. We have discussed about the rhyming words. Now, I hope you have remembered that what are rhyming words. So, rhyming words are the words that ends with same sounds. So, whatever the words that ends with the same sound, the end, whenever a word ends, it ends with the almost same sounds. Okay. Here the example also I have taken. The examples of that I have discussed in my last class, that is hen, pen, bat, mat, and hear and fear. All right, so these are all ends with the same sound. So this is all about rhyming words. Now, what is the learning outcome of today's class? The learning outcome of today's class is the students will be able to read with correct pronunciation, modulation, and intonation, and also students will also understand the new words and its meaning. Okay, so that means today I am going to do the reading of this particular poem. And also I'm going to discuss the new words along with its picture and meaning. Okay, so let us move towards our next slide. All right, so this is the poem. So here I'm going to read out the poem. Please open your book, put your finger wherever I read this poem and try to understand it and try to know the spellings and their pronunciation well. All right. Flip, flap, flip, flap, rises my kite, up and up in the sky that is so blue and bright. Flip, flap, flip, flap, goes my kite, sometimes to my left and sometimes to my right. Flip, flap, flip, flap, flies my kite, high and high above, it fills me with delight. Okay, this is all about this poem. So, I will be doing the explanation of this poem in my next class. Now, let us move towards the new words. The first new word that we have got in this lesson is rises. Now, what is the meaning of rises? So, rises means goes up. The spelling of rises is R-I-S-E-S, rises. That means goes up. Now, in this picture, you can see the sun rises in the east. We generally say that sun rises in the east. That means the sun goes up. Whenever it rises, it just goes up in the sky. That is the meaning of rises. Our next word is bright, B-R-I-G-H-T, bright. That means filled with light. Bright means filled with light, very much of bright color. Now here in this bright, you can see the picture of the sun. The sun is shining very, very brightly. Okay, so this is all about bright, bright color. The next word is left, L-E-F-T, left. Left means what? It is a direction. Left means direction. So you can see this is the left direction symbol. The next one is right. So right means also the direction that is opposite to the left. Direction that is opposite to left. So you can see this is the symbol of the direction. Now of right. The next word is evoke, A-V-O-V-E, evoke. Evoke means at a higher level than something. Evoke means evoke something. So here in this picture you can see the cat is sitting above the chair and a rat is sitting below the chair. So you can, from here you can differentiate the meaning of evoke and below. The next word is delight, D-E-L-I-G-H-T, delight. Delight means happiness, joyful. So here I have given a face of a smiley. That means it is very happy, it is very much smiling. So it is the meaning of delight. Understood? I hope you all have understood the new words well. Now, the questions for assessing competency, that means now let us discuss the two of the questions that will assess what you have understood. The number one is, what are the things that we need to keep in mind while reading a poem? So while reading a poem, what are the things that we should keep in our mind? So it is for you students, just think about it. And the next one is, give the meaning of the following words. So the following words are left, delight and blue. So please note down these two questions from here. I will be discussing this question in my live class. All right. So now we have come to the summary of today's class. So first we have done the reading of the poem and also we have discussed the new words along with its meaning and pictures. So that is all for today, dear students. I hope everything is clear to you. So that's all for today. Thank you. And